Still starting your TypeScript app manually every time you save a file. That's a productivity killer. In this video, I will show you how to integrate Nodemon with TypeScript for automatic reloading. By the end, you will even see a faster alternative that replaces both tools with a single command. Let's dive in. Before we set up anything, let's make sure we have got the right tools. We will assume you already have Node.js, NPM, and Nodemon installed. If Nodemon isn't installed yet, don't worry, I have linked the full installation video tutorial in the description below. Now, let's move into the project folder and create a src folder to store our TypeScript code. If this is a new project, initialize it using npm init-y. Let's install a few TypeScript-specific packages you will need for development. TypeScript is only needed during development to transpile TS files. Your production environment usually runs compiled JavaScript. TSNode is useful for running TypeScript directly in dev, but again, not necessary in production. TypeScript gives us autocomplete and type safety for Node.js features in VS Code and during compilation. By installing these as dev dependencies, we keep our production environment lean and avoid polluting global installs. Now that our dependencies are set, let's configure TypeScript properly. This command sets up a TypeScript configuration with sensible defaults and prefills the options we care about most. Let's break it down. Init creates a new tsconfig.json file that tells TypeScript how to compile your code. Root.dir src tells TypeScript that the source code lives inside the src folder to keep your project clean and organized. Out.dir dist keeps TypeScript and output files separate by saving compiled JavaScript files in dist folder. Setting ESModule interrupt to true enables the use of default import syntax with common JS modules like Express. We're going to set up a basic Express server that runs on port 3000. This gives us something real to test with Nodemon later. So even if you aren't familiar with Express, it's just a component tool here. First, we need to install Express. Then we will create a TypeScript file in the src folder. Inside the TypeScript file, we import the Express library, initialize the app, define a simple route that displays a message in the browser, and finally listen on port 3000 for incoming requests. Now, let's get Nodemon to work with our TypeScript app. Remember, Nodemon doesn't understand TypeScript out of the box, so we need to tell it how to handle TS files properly. Inside the root directory of your project, create a nodemon.json file. We only want Nodemon to watch the src folder, which contains our actual TypeScript source files. We will ignore the dist folder, so Nodemon doesn't get stuck in an infinite loop watching files it just compiled. This ensures Nodemon only reacts to change in TS files. It won't restart for JS, JSON, or other file types. This tells Nodemon to run our app with tsnode, and specifically the server.ts entry file we created earlier. Now run the app, then update the greeting message in server.ts and save the file. Watch what happens in the terminal. Nodemon detects the file change and automatically restarts the app using tsnode, and you will see the new message when you refresh the browser. Note that if you check your dist folder right now, it's empty, and that's expected. That's normal when using tsnode because it compiles TypeScript in memory only and doesn't emit any JS files into your dist directory or anywhere else on disk. If you are already using Babel for JavaScript in your project and want to add TypeScript support without switching tools, or want faster transpilation with more plugin flexibility, you can use this Babel Nodemon setup to compile TypeScript instead of the TypeScript compiler or tsnode. First, we need to install the required packages. These packages give Babel the ability to understand both modern JavaScript and TypeScript syntax. Then we need to create a babelrc file to tell Babel to use the TypeScript preset for parsing TS files and the env preset for compiling to compatible JavaScript. He Here we are telling Nodemon to use Babel node to run TS5 directly. The extension's TS flag is crucial. It tells Babel to treat TS5 as valid input. This setup gives you a faster transpilation and allows you to use the Babel blogging ecosystem. But we still need TSC numit as it doesn't check type safety. Keep in mind that Babel node is intended for development only and shouldn't be used in production environments. Now let's look at a tool that replaces both Nodemon and TS node in one shot. TS node dev. It's fast, simple, and perfect for development. First, install it as a dev dependency. Then run your app using npx tsnodedev src/server.ts. That's it. No need for a nodemon.json. It washes your files, clears the cache, and restores the app automatically. If you want the smoothest dev experience and don't need to emit JS files, tsnodedev is hard to beat. It's fast and needs minimal config. Now you have learned how to integrate Nodemon with TypeScript using tsnode, how to use Babel with Nodemon for faster TypeScript transpilation, and how to simplify everything with TS Node Dev. No matter which setup you choose, you now have a powerful and modern dev workflow that keeps your app running smoothly while you code. Whether you stick with Nodemon and TS Node, use Babel with Nodemon, or switch to TS Node Dev, you now have a smooth modern TypeScript dev workflow that saves time and keeps you focused on building. Thanks for watching and see you on the next one.